Started, ain't no need in Holland, stop now. You all across the line, ain't no option for a opt out. Put these J's off in your ass and only pull my foot and sock out. Hitting hard like Clover Lane at night, that Rocky got knocked out. Don't let me demonstrate one of these knockout classes. I can add a little black and blue to your complexion. $200 J.
What up, YouTube? This your boy Down Low back with another requested review. This one is to C Style, Average Life. And you know what? This project is cool, man. It's really not like a game changer or anything, man. But yet, you do put out some solid music on here. Like, my favorite songs off this project is TV. I like that We Out Here, and I like that Cadillac. But as I listen to this project, man, I realize that there are just some core fundamental issues that you really need to address when it comes to just skill-wise in music. So let's prioritize it, man, and start off with maybe the most important because it takes the longest to develop, which these are your lyrics, dude. Now, where you at right now is a decent level, but there's massive amounts of improvements that need to be done here. Now, what you need to work on, man, is to start using some metaphors, using some wordplay, and increasing your vocab. Now, metaphors pretty much is using something that has nothing to do with what you were talking about, man, but yet you're using that to explain what you're talking about. Here's a great example of it. Like, I write an article every day, and every so often, I'll make a metaphor. And one that I wrote a while ago, man, was talking about how Batman relates to the underground rapper. Like, on face value, Batman in no way relates to the underground rapper, you dig? But yet, when you start breaking it down, you begin to see what I'm talking about here. See, Batman made a name for himself in Gotham City because every night he went out and beat the asses of everybody he needed to beat the ass of. And which, from doing that, the criminal underworld knew who the fuck he was, and from there he went viral all over fucking Gotham to the point that he built a buzz in that damn city that everybody knows him. Same thing could go for fucking rappers, but that's pretty much what metaphors are. Wordplay is exactly what it sounds like, man. You're pretty much just playing with your words. Like, and there's a ton of different ways you go about it. Your creativity is the only limitation here, but I can give you one very, very basic example. I came across this rapper a little minute ago, and he said this: if you try me, I'll be slapping on your bitch ass. And later on tonight, be slapping on your bitch ass. Notice he said the same exact phrase twice, but yet each time it meant something different. And to increase your vocabulary, man, there's a bunch of different ways. Like Eminem, he read the damn dictionary, studied it, and started using actual words from there. You gotta understand that knowledge and words are your tools here in order to become better lyricists. The more you fucking know, the more you train with it, the better you're going to be. The more you implement all of these, man, the more potent and better your punchlines will be. Your next priority is working on your flow and delivery. A lot of people think that these are two of the same thing, but they're not. See, your flow is how you're rhyming on the beat, and your delivery is the enthusiasm that you have about it. But yet, in order to solve both of these issues that you have, it all surrounds around the same damn thing, which is coming into the studio with all of your lyrics completely memorized, like you know them joints back and forth, to the point that you don't need any paper to recite that shit, man. Like, you're not focused on what you need to say, you're focused on how you need to say it. See, the thing is, the more you practice it, the easier it becomes. The people that's been memorizing lyrics for years, they're able to memorize the joints damn near as soon as they write them. And the last thing you definitely need to work on, man, is your consistency. Because as I listed only 3 tracks off this project that I really like, you had a ton of fucking songs on here, dude. Like, what consistency is being at your best on every damn track that you release, man. Now, how you work on this is exactly like how the best in the music industry has worked on it, from T.I. to Michael Jackson to you fucking name them. What they do is they record a lot and release a little. Pretty much for your next project, man, I'd say record 50, 60 songs. Out of that 50, 60, select maybe the best 7 and only put those towards the project, man. But yet, never forget about the extra 53, because you can use those as straight up promotion leading up to it. But overall, the project isn't that bad, man, and everybody out there who's watching this, please go ahead, check it on. The link to it is in the description below. Leave him some feedback, tell him what you believe he can do better. I hope you enjoyed the show. You can follow me at Twitter up there, And you can go to downloadpaz.com, that's down there, to read today's article.